After Uzodinma returns to Imo with Operation Stop Hoodlums, see what happened to him. You should not be surprised at what Uzodinma is doing right now because he is known for it. He is known for it, and that is what he is known for: the use of military force. And that has always been his problem, and he has refused to receive advice. Do you understand? He has refused to receive advice. I remember Nnamdi Kanu warning him assiduously that, look, with this that has just happened to you, it is better you relocate to Abuja. Do you understand? It is better you relocate to Abuja. But in this very broadcast, we are told that Uzodinma remained adamant and even decide to get worse. Immediately, Uzodinma called an emergency meeting with the other governors in the southeast, and together, because of the happening in Imo, together they quickly formed they quickly worked on the operation of the Ibibiago security, and they make sure that they are handed over with all of the weapons that they need for operation. Just, you understand? So Uzodinma still went on to liaise with other security outfits, both the state and the federal security outfit. In fact, he just got himself surrounded with all the forces that he believes will stand by him at this difficult time. Well, how long is this going to last? Have they not been surrounding him since? What have they been able to achieve? They have not been able to achieve anything as far as I'm concerned. Instead, things keep getting worse by the day. And surrounding himself with all of this security even makes things to get worse. Because then he is now inviting more war to himself. Do you understand now? He's inviting more war to himself. So what are we saying? Both Uzodinma and the other governors are putting their lives at risk the more, because by equipping the Ibibiago with all of these weapons, they are telling the hoodlums, the gunmen, that they should come. You should understand that they should come, that they are ready for them. You understand? Okay. Let's see what the newly formed security outfit will be willing and be able to achieve with this, because the whole thing is still looking so laughable and strange and unbelieving. So let us see what they are able to do or willing to do or will be able to do, because it's not just by word, but we are talking about action. That is what the IPOP and Eastern Security Network are known for. All right, let's quickly look into the content itself. You see, my viewers, I keep getting worried each time I hear of this statement coming from Uzodinma without him trying to make a change and a move, and it's very, very bad. Let's quickly look into the contents. 1 week after Imo State Governor Hope Uzodinma's hometown was attacked, he, Uzodinma, has returned back to his state to continue his official duties, especially to vehemently end hoodlums attacking Imolites. Part of the arrangement of the governor was to set in motion the Imo State chapter of the Abibiago, meet with security heads in the state. He would also meet with traditional rulers as well as a special section with stakeholders of the state across party lines to collectively deal with the situation. A source said Uzodinma does not talk much. He believes in action. His back and action will also speak. You think while he is away that he was not doing anything in regards to the security lives and properties in Imo. Watch and see the action. Those behind the actions or attacks should continue. We are not telling them to stop, but they will be exposed for immolates. He continues. So all these are for election in 2023. Uzodinma administration is not thinking of 2023. We are thinking of how to provide governance to the people of the state. It's a pure lie. Stop it. Stop telling the lie. What are you saying? Which after good governance, an administration that came in and started favoring the Fulani Janjaweeds, an administration that came in and start going after the Igbos, getting them arrested, taking what belongs to the Igbos to the Fulani herdsmen. They forcefully collected lands from the Igbos and gave it to the Fulani herdsmen to set up cattle markets. As far as I'm concerned, Uzodinma has made life unbearable for the people of the Southeast, and what he is receiving right now is the repercussion of all of his evil deeds. So nobody should just try to carry out a cover-up for Uzodinma. He deserves it. Can you imagine? Look at the day his house was set ablaze. See how the masses were celebrating. See how they were celebrating. Didn't you see it yourself? Or do I replay the broadcast for you? It's there for you to listen. It's there for you to listen. I don't need to replay it. Go to my channel and you get it. Let's stop deceiving ourselves. Everybody know that Uzodinma hasn't done well. So let us stop covering him up. Let's say the truth where the truth is. You understand? Uzodinma is a nightmare. He's a nightmare to the Southeast. And Mbaka have said it. Primate Odile have said it. That what Imo State is going through today is because Uzodinma is not the real governor of Imo State. That Imo State will continue experiencing this until Yehuda is returned to power. Let me hear from you and know what you have to say about this. If you are new, click on the subscription button as well as bell button to receive more updates. Thank you.